The news of an effective COVID-19 vaccine is welcome news for the world, but a significant proportion of the population now has a new dilemma. These are people who suffer from needle phobia, which is surprisingly common. Needle phobias are often deeply ingrained from childhood, and even the sight of a needle can evoke absolute terror, and some needle phobics will actually faint. This is why this video does not contain any pictures of needles or blood. So what is the best way to get rid of a needle phobia? The answer to this varies depending on the type of needle phobia. The cause of the fear can be any of the following: the fear of fainting, the fear of pain, the fear of blood, or even the fear of being controlled or restrained, possibly as a result of a bad experience of an injection as a child. Or it can be a combination of any of the above. For all types of needle phobia, systematic desensitization is the most effective way to overcome it, but with a few very important caveats. For people whose needle phobia causes them to faint, they need to use the applied tension method to prevent them from fainting during the systematic desensitization. Fainting occurs when the blood pressure suddenly drops due to the fear response, a phenomenon known as vasovagal syncope. The applied tension method teaches the needle phobe to tense certain muscles in order to keep the blood pressure up, which prevents them from fainting. For people who have had a traumatic experience with a needle as a child, they may need help dealing with the trauma in addition to the systematic desensitization. So what is systematic desensitization? Systematic desensitization involves gradual exposure to the thing that the needle phobe fears. It starts with exposure to something that makes the needle phobe mildly uncomfortable, like looking at a cartoon picture of a needle. Then something more difficult, like a real picture of a needle. Then perhaps imagining the needle procedure itself. Or various other small steps, eventually leading up to actually handling a needle or something sharp. The therapist helps them manage their anxiety at each stage. Systematic desensitization can be done over a few hours in one session, or over multiple sessions over days, weeks, or even months. It depends on the severity of the phobia and the individual. It needs a lot of determination from the needle phobe and a lot of patience from the therapist. It is important that the therapist does not push the needle phobe too far, too fast. However, gentle encouragement should be used. There are various types of therapies that use systematic desensitization, each with their pros and cons. Hypnotherapy, eye movement, desensitization and reprocessing, also known as EMDR, cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT. CBT includes systematic desensitization, but also teaches you how avoidance and protective behaviors, known as safety behaviors, increase the fear response in the long term. It also provides tools to deal with the negative thoughts and beliefs that drive the phobia. CBT is seen as the gold standard for anxiety disorders and phobias in many countries. But challenging long-held beliefs and behaviours can be difficult. EMDR is not so well known, and considered by some to be an alternative therapy. But over recent years, there has been more and more evidence for it being effective, particularly for dealing with previous trauma. So it may well be suited to someone who has had a bad experience with needles in the past. Hypnotherapy uses suggestion, relaxation, and systematic desensitization. Systematic desensitization is difficult, but hypnotherapy can make it easier by relaxing you. However, this may not be suitable for people who faint, as being relaxed causes the blood pressure to drop, and it may also be difficult to combine the applied tension method with hypnotherapy. The other problem with hypnotherapy is that some therapists have only done a short course in hypnotherapy and not trained in anything else, so their skill set may be limited. So when seeking a therapist for treatment for needle phobia, do your research. Try to find someone who is trained in all or most of these therapies. Many counsellors and psychotherapists have. And if you are prone to fainting, also ask them if they have any experience of the applied tension method. An experienced therapist will be able to choose the best treatment approach for your individual needs, rather than being restricted to just the one therapy that they have trained in. If you have a needle phobia, I hope this video will help you find the right treatment for you. Please share this video to help the millions of other people who suffer from this awful phobia. If you're interested in learning about anxiety, please subscribe to my channel where I regularly release videos about phobias and anxiety disorders. The key to beating anxiety is knowledge. Let's share that knowledge.